Good morning, everyone. Don't you all clean up nicely? Congratulations, class of 2023. We made it. Even those of you who went to the 9-0 at 5 in the morning, y'all made it to the 8 a.m. ceremony. Marshall, I'm looking at you. We rallied for 4 years, so of course we're gonna rally for the last day. I thought I'd go back to the first time many of us first sat here together, on August 27, 2019, for new student convocation. I came to convocation with my 3 random freshman year roommates, and I couldn't have known it then, but these 3 women would become my fiercest friends at USC. A few weeks after convocation, as classes picked up, I decided I really wanted to be in an a cappella group, you know, as we all do in our freshman year. I had done choir in high school, and Pitch Perfect had a chokehold on our generation. So every day, I trekked past CPA, and I considered auditioning. But something stopped me every time. My insecurities flared. I wasn't good enough, I would sound silly, and on the last day of auditions, I came back to my room, just convinced it wasn't in the cards. My roommate Sarah asked me how the audition went, and embarrassed, I lied. Something about just not having the time to stop by. She saw right through that, considering I had come back every day to our dorm room that year to take a 2-hour nap. She looked at me and she said, "Well, you have time right now." So she rallied my suite mates, Nisha and Charlotte, and they all marched me from the village to CPA. They stood outside the audition room and they vowed they would not budge until I tried out. Filled with this borrowed confidence, I auditioned for multiple groups, bouncing from room to room. Now, you would think that auditioning for almost every single a cappella group at USC would increase your probability of getting into one. Spoiler alert, I did not get into a single one. I learned that day that everyone can sing, but not all of us can sing well. If I had, it definitely would have gone to my head. So honestly, for all of our sakes, this was a win-win. I may not have gotten into an a cappella group, but I remember calling my mom a week after and saying, "I just have a really, really good feeling my roommates and I are going to be the best of friends." 4 years later, I still live with them. I've laughed with them. I've cried in their arms. I've even gone clubbing with one of their parents who asked me to mention that that was just a regular Friday for them. While people like to joke that college is all about finding your romantic soulmates, I've come to find that college is all about falling in love with your friends. And somewhere along the way, their confidence and support helps us fall in love with ourselves. And it's not just friends, it's an ecosystem of support. It's our incredible professors, mentors, and classmates who have shaped our college experience and helped us dream bigger. And of course, our families whose support and sacrifice helped get us here. To my younger brother, Anuj, thank you for your unconditional love. And to my parents, mom and dad, first-gen immigrants from India, you have taught me so much more about entrepreneurship and risking it all for a dream than any classroom ever could. The pandemic took a lot from all of us, but it gave me the chance to spend more time with you, and I'm always thankful for that. Speaking of the pandemic, I know I have to talk about it. While we didn't share that physical space that we called home, our relationships created spaces that transcended time zones, geography, boundaries. I think my hat's about to come off. That's okay. And while I've come to love the various neighborhoods of Los Angeles and campus itself, I learned in the pandemic how a community can define itself beyond its physical space. That being said, all of us were, are, and may continue to be inhabitants of LA, a physical space and community that has given us so much. And I think we ought to thank the city and its residents for giving us a home. And we ought to think deeply about the impacts we as students and we as universities have on this community and communities all across the world. The world is faced with some grave problems: war, climate crises, pandemics. And there are times I feel so small and so helpless in the face of these problems. But as I look out and I see all of us, I think that we are just the group of people to advocate for change and fight to see it through. We learned how to adapt in the spring of 2020, and we haven't stopped using that skill since. But beyond just the work we do, I hope we also think about who we choose to be, the kinds of friends and mentors we are for others. May we all be the people waiting outside audition rooms, and may we never forget all of those who stood outside for us. This semester, on a day hammocking in McCarthy Quad, I came across this quote from one of my favorite authors, Arundhati Roy. She says, "Another world is not only possible, she is on her way. And on a quiet day, I can hear her breathing. And on this beautiful Southern California day, I can hear her breathing. And we, class of 2023, are well on our way. Congratulations and fight on!"